Good morning. We are now going to have our opening prayer by Melissa. You guys can go ahead and stand for our opening prayer.
Let's have our word of prayer. Heavenly Father, please help everybody to be safe and safe. That's finally. Congratulations. In Jesus' name, we pray in your name, amen.
Hi. Good morning, everyone. Buenos dias a todos. We want to welcome you to the kindergarten graduation and the pre-K promotion. Vamos a dar la bienvenida a cada uno de ustedes a la graduación de kindergarten y la promoción de pre-kinder. You guys ready? Yes? Yes? We're excited to be able to have graduation for you guys this year. We thank God for this moment. It's been a crazy year, right? But did we have fun? I tell you, parents, you guys have great kids. This is my favorite group, okay? They helped me rehab from my knee surgery because they would chase me around the gym and I had to run. So they wouldn't let me go. So I'm proud of you guys. Good job. Eli, Andres, Catalina, Melissa, Lucas, Nicholas. Congratulations. There you go. Imani, Sage, Amir, Yosef, Genesis, and Mateo. All right, remember all their names. Thank God, finally, yes. I hope you enjoy graduation today. May God bless you. Thank you guys for entrusting your children to us here at Houston Adventist Academy. Enjoy the programming.
Just like Pastor Smith said, this is also my favorite class, at least for this year, right? Because I got others in the audience that I've taught before, so I can't be biased, but I love all my children. I always tell them, once a regalado kid, always a regalado kid. And I even have some seniors that'll be graduating this Sabbath and Sunday that I taught back in first and second grade or third and fourth. And so it's amazing to get to see them grow and learn and become all kinds of young men and women of God and doing so much for this this world. So we're going to go ahead and begin with our program, and I want to start by saying that, like I told my kids already, I'm probably going to cry on more than one occasion during our program today, so please excuse me. I am an emotional person, and I'm very proud of my kiddos, and just look at those faces. It's been amazing to come each day and see those smiling faces. Sorry. It's exciting to get to put on this program for you guys, and I hope you all enjoy. So this year, one of our most exciting times, we're worship and Bible. That's the first thing we do each morning. It's what's important to us to start our day. And I was glad to see when they filled out something that they're going to get later in their baggies, that a lot of them chose the Bible. When we asked them what their favorite subject was, they chose Bible as their favorite subject. And others chose math and science. And, you know, everybody has their own likes and favorite things. But it was so amazing to see so many of them pick Bible as their favorite subject, because that's what we're here for. You know, we want them to have a relationship with Jesus. And they've definitely helped me grow in my spiritual life this year. So, to start off this year, we learned a memory verse each week. And so we've picked out three verses, as you see in the program, that we're going to recite today. These are some of our favorite ones. And then we're going to sing a song about how unique we are, how God has created each one of us. And as you'll see later on, there's certain talents that your children have that I've picked out to highlight because I was able to see that throughout the year. And then we'll have a poem performance by our kindergarten graduates that are so excited to be moving on to first grade. some of the themes in our Bible this year. We've learned to love God with all our heart. We've learned to praise Him and only Him. We've learned that we are part of God's family and that He loves us no matter what, and that we are to share that good news to others. And so our verses today that the kiddos are going to perform have those themes in mind. So please enjoy. All right, Pre-K and Cave, you guys can stand up and get in your verse lines for me. Thank you.
Thank you.
Our next part is a special part because without each of you, we couldn't function here at our school. We wouldn't have all our wonderful children here at our school. And so we wanted to give a special thank you for all of your support, all of your prayers, all of your hard work, everything you put into having your children be ready for class and having the things that they need. And anytime I asked for anything for the classroom, you were willing to give and to put forth. And so we wanted to give a special thank you to each of you for your hard work. The kiddos have a special rose to give to their mom and dad. So if you guys would stand up, then your child can find you. And they're going to give you a big hug and say, I love you, because you are so, so important to them. Okay? So any family members of the graduates, they're going to come to you. So if they can find you, if you don't mind standing up.
Some kids think their parents make too many rules. Clean your room, make your bed, pick up your dirty socks. But God says when you obey and respect your parents as the leaders of your home, then life will be better for you.
Deuteronomy 5, verse 16. Honor your father and your mother, as the Lord your God has commanded you, that your days may be long, and that it may be well with you.
Honor your father and your mother as the Lord your God has commanded you. Honor your father and your mother as the Lord has commanded you. That your days may be long, that it may be well with you, with you. Honor your father and your mother as the Lord has commanded you.
Next, we want to recognize some special individuals that have also, just like the parents, really helped our classroom and made it run. And I have some special things that the kiddos put together for them because we really love them and we spend a lot of time with them, and we want to give them our thanks this morning. Our first person that we want to recognize is Miss G. She is our teacher's aide. She takes the little ones to recess. She helps me with classroom activities. She's helped me tremendously with this graduation. And so the kiddos have made a special gift. I didn't practice walking while I'm doing this, so sorry about that. Have a special gift that the students have put together. They made a little bag with their little hands so that Miss G can remember the little hands forever. We wanted to give her a good thing. So what do we say to Miss G, boys and girls? We love our Miss G. We love our Miss G. She, if you can't tell right now, is always all smiles. She is, yes, super sweet with the kiddos, and they love her. Anytime they see Miss G, they're like, Miss G, and there they go off running to give her a hug. Our next individual actually couldn't be here, but if she's watching online, Granny June has been so awesome to us this year. She has come each week as she could when she's feeling well to read to the children and to give them the story and to do a craft, and they always have a lot of fun. And so the children have also made a little bag for Granny June to say thank you. So what do we say to Granny June, boys and girls, in case she's watching online? We love you, Granny June. Thank you so much. Another individual, Mrs. Pimentel, has done so many donations to our classroom this year, from books to activities. She's helped me tremendously, if you can tell by our spread in the back. She and Granny June helped me yesterday put some of that stuff together and then finish this morning early. And so we wanted to give her a special gift as well. What do we say to Miss Robin? Then we have our senior, Miss Lauren. So this semester, the seniors, had a lighter load, and some of them ride the bus at the end of the day. And even though they didn't have to, they're not able to go home, some of those seniors came to help in our classroom. Come here, Mama. You okay? Oh. Come here. And so Miss Lauren, this semester, has helped us tremendously by playing with them at recess, doing activities with me, cleaning the room, getting stuff together. And so she's actually class of 2021 as well. She's graduating on Sunday as a senior, just like you guys are. And we wanted to give her a special gift to send her off to college and wish her well and God's blessings and prayers. So thank you, Miss Lauren. What do we say to Miss Lauren? We enjoyed having her in our classroom, didn't we? We also want to thank our photographer, Mr. Pete. I know that day was a Friday, a long day for our pictures. But if you can see the display of the wonderful pictures there that we have of our beautiful graduates, they're yours to keep at the end of the day, so you'll get to take your graduate photo home. Just please leave the stand as we're using them for our seniors on Saturday and Sunday. But you're welcome to take the pictures there. He did a fabulous job, so thank you to Mr. Pete. There's also pictures of your children hanging there that you'll get to keep as well. And then you'll get the class picture in their baggies a little bit later. We want to thank Mr. Arturo. He's around taking our pictures today as well. And we want to also thank the Figueroa family who have provided some of our refreshments today, as well as Sweet Things Cypress. She's a friend of mine, and she was able to make that beautiful cake with your children's names on it. So if you haven't had a chance to look at it, you can do that. And Aranda's Bakery, the Figueroa family have also brought things from there as well. So we want to thank them for that. And now come some awards. I loved if you happened to watch the 8th grade graduation last night. Pastor Jafia was the speaker, and he was able to pick out some characteristics of each of his students that he's had in Bible class. I had already planned to do something similar. I love finding spiritual talents or spiritual things that the children have that I want to highlight at the end of the year. And so I've picked something from each of them that have stood out to me, that I've noticed, that was special. Now, that's not the only talent they have. Your children are very, very talented. But I picked out a certain one that stood out to me to highlight today. And it comes with a little verse, too, because these are all biblical characteristics that they possess. And I, like I mentioned at the beginning, I grew this year myself. I really enjoyed learning from them. As much as they've learned from me, I probably learned more. But these are just awesome things that I was able to watch on a daily basis from the students. So as I call your name and I say your characteristics, you guys can come and get your certificate, and then you'll put it underneath your chair to pick up a little later, okay? All right, so our first characteristic is the award of generosity. And the award of generosity goes to Genesis this year. Genesis always brought the most adorable little toys, and she was always so willing to have everybody play with them and everybody share with them. She wanted everybody to enjoy everything she had. So our award of generosity goes to Genesis. Our next award is the award of honesty. Elizabeth has the award of honesty this year. She is honest in everything she does, whether it's to tell us how she's feeling, if she's tired, or, you know, she didn't get a good night's sleep, or she's just cranky. She will tell you. She'll be honest. But she's also honest and pure in heart, that when we talked about Bible and Bible stories, she was able to, you know, really connect and have that purity of heart and that honesty that was raw. And so our honesty award goes to Elizabeth. Our next award is the award for cooperation. Amir gets the award for cooperation. And Amir came later on in the year, but he fit right in when he came. And probably the most difficult time, he came in January when we were doing all those weeks of online teaching and learning. My husband had just been sick. It was a rough time, but he came in and fit right into the program like he had been here with our classroom the whole year. And anytime I ask Amir for anything, he is willing to help in a heartbeat. So our award for cooperation goes to Amir. Our next award is the award for perseverance. And this young man has shown me that this year, no matter what I put in front of him, even if at times it was difficult for him to grasp or to do, he had that willing spirit to persevere all the way through, no matter what I put in front of him. And I am so, so amazed at the progress he has made. So our award for perseverance goes to Lucas. Good job, buddy. Our next award is for responsibility. This young lady is my right-hand woman in the classroom. If I need something, if I need to send her somewhere, if I need her to get something done, Melissa is it. I will call on Melissa, my right-hand woman, and she gets the award for responsibility. Our next award is the award of compassion. And in the Bible, Jesus shows compassion all the time. And when I see this little girl, I see Jesus in her. She's very quiet, but very kind and very loving and very gentle in everything she does. So the award of compassion goes to Catalina. This young lady also shows the gentleness that I would see in Jesus. Whenever she wants to help others, whenever she's very motherly, if I could say it in that way. She was like mother hen to our little ones. She always wanted to, I'll help you and I'll do this and I can take her. And she's just so gentle in spirit and so meek. So our award of gentleness goes to Sage. This young man brings joy into our lives each and every day. He's our classroom clown, if you can say, but we rely on him for the jokes and the laughter because we know at any moment, if he's allowed, he is going to be silly and he's going to be funny and he's going to be on the floor rolling somewhere. But he brings that joy that we need each day, even on the days that can be a little bit rough, including when we were online and it it was a little bit rough at times. Our joyfulness award goes to Andres. This next young man always had something to say during our Bible class. He had a response and a connection with every story and everything that we did. He always wanted to share what he got out of that story, what kind of spiritual connection he had. So our faith award goes to Imani. This next award is the award of discernment. This young man has so much going in his brain. He has so much information. He amazes me sometimes. He knows facts that I don't even know. And they're interesting facts. I know he's going to be a doctor or a big scientist sometime, because in anything we were studying and anything we were doing, he had some tidbits, some fact of information. So my Nicholas gets the award of discernment, which is a big word, but it just means you have so much knowledge in there, honey. Good job. This young man brought me something probably every day. He made a little paper person, or he made me a little boat. He was always creating. You guys know, huh? He was always creating something. And that, again, to me, is a characteristic of God, because, you know, he created the earth. He's made so many things for us to enjoy. And he's given Joseph the creativity that he's going to need to do amazing things and to continue to create as he grows up. So our creativity award goes to Joseph. And last but not least, we have a friend in our Matthew. He is so friendly, not just to the boys, not just to the girls, not just to the teachers, not just to the students in the other classes. Matthew is just a friend to all. He's the sweetest boy you can find. So our award of friendship goes to Matthew. And boys and girls, I congratulate you on all those characteristics. You have that and much more. Later on, mommies and daddies can read the little verse that goes along with your characteristic, your talent that Jesus has given you. And now we are going to move on to our slide presentation. As you know, because I post daily on our private Facebook group, that I take a lot of pictures. I like to remember things that we've done throughout the year. So it was a little bit difficult to come up with a slideshow because I had thousands upon thousands upon thousands of pictures to go through. And even when I favored them, I had over 1,200 pictures, which I then had to downsize. These are some of our favorites. Some are silly, some are serious, some are just plain fun. So I hope you are able to enjoy our little bit of our year in review of what we've done this year with your wonderful children. Enjoy.
Promise with a capital P. I can be anything, anything God wants me to be.
Possibility, you are a promise with a capital P. You are a great big bundle of potentiality. And if you listen, you'll hear God's voice. And if you're trying, he'll help you make the right choices. You're a promise to be anything God wants you to be.
Something. It doesn't matter what your name is, or where you live, or who your daddy is, or how big you are, or what you look like. Hey, what do you look like? Are you short, tall, fat, skinny, got holes in your tennis shoes and freckles on your nose? It doesn't matter a bit. You can be exactly what God wants you to be, and He has something very special in mind for you. It might be climbing mountains or sailing the sea, helping sick people get well, or singing a song. Whatever it is, you can do it.
You can go anywhere that He wants you to go. You can be anything that He wants you to be. You can climb the high mountain, you can cross the wide sea. You're a great big promise, you see.
Yeah. believe you're here now. Tiny dream come true, the answer to a prayer now. I'm so in love with you, couldn't wait to meet you. Hope you like your name. I get the funny feeling life will never be the same. Safe and sound, you're here with me now, like I hoped you'd be. Safe and sound, you're here with me now, and that's all I'll ever need. The world's a scary place here, but baby, it's alright. I'll make sure the coast is clear, so you can just sleep tight. But if you're afraid of monsters, like everybody is, I'll be right beside you, closer than a kiss. Safe and sound, I'm here with you now, and you will. Heaven's love may reach you every single day. So baby, close your eyes now and say a prayer with me. Lord, I lay me down to sleep now, but I know I will be safe and sound. You're here with us now, and we will always be. Safe and sound, you're here with us now, and that's all we'll ever, all we'll ever need. You're all we'll ever
need. See, I told you I'd cry. That slideshow gets me every time. A special thank you to my husband, Gilbert, who put our slideshow together. And I know it was a little long, but he texted me that altogether, without the last week's photos, I had 5,436 photos to sort through. So those are our best of the best after the favorites. And so I hope you enjoyed. And now we're going to do what we've all been waiting for. We're going to get these kinder graduates and our pre-K graduates promoted to kinder. So before I do that, while Pastor Smith heads up, I wanted to share, can you give me one of those little bags, Miss G, if you don't mind? Each student is going to get their diploma, of course, because they're graduating. And I have it just really quick. We put together some little special things inside the bag for each of the graduates, besides some little gifts for their graduation. There is a little book inside that's a tiny little yearbook just for our class, with some of our favorite pictures for you to have to look through the years, because your little ones are not going to be this little forever. And one of these days, very soon, they're going to be graduating like our seniors are on Sunday. And so that's a little token of our year, so that you can remember it by. You're also going to get inside the manila folder their class picture that they took when they took their graduation picture, so that you also have that. And something that I wanted to do for each of them, of the graduates, I'm starting it in their kinder years, so Andres and then Elizabeth, you'll get your book next year, is I got every graduate all the places you'll go, because I know that they're going to go amazing places and do amazing things. And so what I've done is I've written a little note inside for each of them, and then I put a little paper as a fun tradition for them each year to take their book to their next teacher and have them sign it. So by the time that they graduate from high school, if Jesus doesn't return sooner than that, and we hope he does, then we'll have something better than the book in heaven, won't we? But if we're still here, they can have that book at their graduation with all of their teachers' signatures inside from kindergarten all the way to their senior year. And I had planned to write verses inside that go along with each of the pages, but there was 20 verses to write for all 10 kiddos, and it was just not going to happen. But if you're wanting that so that you can write the verses in, so that when you read it to them, it also has a biblical component to it, you're welcome to ask me for it, and I'll pass that along. It's really neat, actually. So each of your children are going to get that in their little baggie so that you have that. All right, without further ado, we're going to begin. Just give me a second to set up. And students, as I call you up, as I say your name, remember you're going to go to Pastor Smith for your diploma. And remember you're going to stay there for a few seconds so that your parents and our photographer can get a nice picture, because we want to remember this moment. And then you're going to go to Miss G, and she's going to move your tassel since you're graduating and give you your little baggie to put under your chair, okay? As I call them up, I am going to share with you some thoughts on life that your children have shared with me. I did some interview questions, and so some of them are a little bit funny, so I wanted to share those with you. So our first graduate is Matthew Amador, and when asked what he wanted to be when he grew up, he said he wanted to be a doctor. How much money will you make? $12. Are you going to get married? He said no, but he wanted to have 5 kids. When asked where he wanted to live, he said at my mom's house, and he would have a black car. And when asked what the best thing about this year was, when we do projects. Let's give a hand to Matthew. Our next graduate is Genesis Barajas. When asked what she wanted to be when she grew up, she said a doctor. She was going to make $10. She does want to get married and have 20 children. When asked where she wanted to live, she said she wants to live in Colombia and have a pink car. And her favorite memory of this school year, she could not come up with one. She said everything. Congrats, Genesis. Our next graduate is Joseph Figueroa. When asked what he wanted to do when he grew up, he said, just be a teenager. How much money will you make? $50. He does not want to get married, but he wants to have 3 children. He wants to live in Mexico and have a blue car. And when asked what his best memory was of this year, was seeing his friends and playing with them. Congratulations, Joseph. Next graduate, Amir Jackson. When asked what he wanted to be when he grew up, he said Spider-Man, and he's going to make $1 million. He does not want to get married, and he wants 0 children. And when asked where he wanted to live, he said in the sky and own a Spider-Man mobile. And the best thing about this school year was Treasure Box. Let's congratulate Amir. Our next graduate is Sage Krause. When asked what she wanted to be when she grew up, she said an artist. She's going to make $20. When I asked her if she wanted to get married, she said maybe. She wants at least 2 children. Where will you live? She said, probably here in Houston. What kind of car will you drive? She's saying, the same car as our new car. So apparently you guys have a new car. Enjoy. And she said, the best thing about this year is art. Let's congratulate Sage. Our next kindergarten graduate is Imani Obonio. When asked what he wanted to be when he grew up, he said a dentist. He's going to make $100. He does want to get married and have 3 children. He wants to live in Africa and own a Lincoln. And when asked the best thing about school this year is doing math with his friends. Let's congratulate Imani. Our next graduate is Nicholas Paragord, and he wants to be a policeman when he grows up, and he will make $100, he said. He does want to get married and have 4 children, live in New York, and he wants to have a truck with big wheels, and his best memory of this year is making new friends. Good job, Nicholas. Congratulations, bud. My Nicholas. Our next kindergarten graduate is Lucas Rodriguez. He wants to be a pirate when he grows up. He wants to make $1,000. He does want to get married, and when asked how many children he wanted to have, he just said a lot. He wants to live in Mexico and own a great car. And the best memory of the school year, he said, was the animal song. He really got into our song today, our butterfly one. Let's congratulate Lucas. All right, our next graduate is Melissa Rodriguez. When asked what she wanted to be when she grew up, she said a teacher. She's gonna make $40. She does not want to get married, but wants 1 child. She wants to live in New Jersey and own a Lamborghini. I don't know if she can do that on a teacher's salary, but the best thing about this year, as she said, was the love and kindness of my teacher, which was super sweet. Thank you, Melissa. Let's congratulate Melissa. Good job. Our next graduate is Catalina Vieira, and she wants to be a doctor when she grows up and make $10. When asked if she wanted to get married, she said, I don't know, but probably. She wants 4 children, live in a big house, but have a small car. And her best memory is for you to be my first teacher. Aww, and I had her big sister Barbara too. So sweet. Let's congratulate Catalina. And now we're gonna move on to our pre-Kers. Even though they're not graduating this year as a kindergarten graduate, we do want to reward them for all of the wonderful things they were able to accomplish this year. So we're going to do a pre-K promotion into kindergarten. So our first one is Andres Castilla, our funny man. He wants to be an artist when he grows up, make $15. He does want to get married and have 4 children. He wants to live in Mexico and have a blue car because that's his favorite color. And his best thing about this year is having fun with friends. Let's congratulate our pre-K-er, now kindergartner, Andres, and he has a button that says, on my way to kindergarten. And last but certainly not least, Elizabeth Ortiz, who wants to be a doctor when she grows up and make $11. She does not want to get married or have any children. When asked where you want to live, she said a house maybe, and have a rainbow car, as everyone should. And her favorite thing about this school year was playing magnets at centers. We'll go here. Good job, Elizabeth. Congrats. Congrats. All right, we're going to put her button on because she is ready for kinder. All right, and now we're going to introduce classes, and in a moment I'm going to call Mrs. Valdenegro because she is our first and second grade teacher, and we want to welcome our new first grade class here in a moment. If you can come on up, Mrs. Valdenegro. So first, let's introduce our new first grade class for the 2021-2022 school year. So all of you that are graduates now, that are first graders, if you could stand up. First graders, stand up. So this, ladies and gentlemen, is our 2021-2022 first grade class. Let's give them a big hand. Good job, everybody. Thank you. Go ahead and have a seat. And then if we can have our new kindergartners go ahead and stand up. And And this, ladies and gentlemen, is our kindergarten class for the 2021-2022 school year. Congratulations. And first graders, your new teacher for next year has a little something that she would like to say to you and give to you. So let's give her our undivided attention, okay?
Good morning, boys and girls. Are you excited to graduate? Are you sure? Are you really excited to graduate? There we go. Well, based on your interviews, you're all going to end up living with Amir and his $1 million. Yeah? And we're excited about that, all your new exciting jobs and careers and things you look forward to. Well, I'm Mrs. Valdenegro, and I teach first and second grade. And I'm excited to welcome you to first grade. And so I have a gift for you. And attached to the gift is something special. Because it says, property of first grader, Houston Adventist Academy. And so if anybody misplaces it, we'll know who to give it to. And each gift is a reminder to you that you're welcome to join us this fall in August 2021 for the next year's group of first graders. In no particular order, the first gift is going to Sage Krause. Fist bump for you. Oh, no, not a fist bump. Okay. All right. Next, we have Melissa Rodriguez. Come on. Do I get a fist bump from you? All right, she's going to do it. Okay, our next gift goes to Catalina Vieira. Can I get a fist bump? No, yes. All right. There's a lot of gifts up here, a lot going on. Okay, next we have Iosa Figueroa. Welcome to first grade. No? Okay. It's all right. Then we have Imani Obanyo. Did I get it right, Imani? All right. That's what I'm talking about. Okay. Welcome to first grade. Next we have Genesis Barajas. Did I say it right? Or do you want me to say Genesis? She's like, whatever. I'm going to take it. It's mine now. Okay, we want to welcome Lucas Rodriguez to first grade. All right, welcome. Next we have the millionaire, Amir Jackson. Come on down. Yeah, here you go. Congratulations. Welcome to first grade. Okay. Then we have Nicholas Paragord. There you go, Nicholas. Yeah, thank you. Welcome. And next is Matthew Amador. Matthew, come on up. Get your welcome gift. And give me a fist bump. All right. Now, who doesn't have one? I know there's somebody. Maybe I got everybody. Is that all 10? Because now, let me make sure. Yes. And on this side. Okay. Now, we have to correct a wrong that was last year. I'll take responsibility for this one. Because there wasn't a ceremony here, the students coming up from kindergarten to first grade did not receive a welcome to first grade gift. And so we would like to right that wrong at this time, and we would like to ask the first graders who are here in our audience now to come on up. You're going to come on up on stage. We also have a gift for you to welcome you to second grade. So can we have our first grade class come on up, please? Give them a hand. We talked them into coming out of class just for this. I know they're sad about that, but not really. Okay, and so they're going to come up here, and we're going to ask them to accept a prize, a welcome gift, and theirs says, property of second grader, Houston Adventist Academy, Juan Carlos Carrillo. All right, welcome. Here we go. The next one is Alicia Castilla. Welcome to second grade. the next student is not here with us this morning because she's on Zoom, which is remarkable because she not only joined our school this year, it's her very first year, but she's actually been an online student all year long. Okay. And next we have Viviana Amador. All right. Welcome to second grade. Then there is Kelly Renee Rosales. Congratulations. Welcome to second grade. And last but not least, we have Santiago Gonzalez. All right. Do we get a fist bump from this group? Yeah. Give them a clap. This is our second grade and first grade class of 2021-2022, right here. Congratulations. Thank you, first grade. Excuse me, second grade. You can take a seat. Yeah, I know. When we call you second grade, you don't know anymore because this is our new first grade. Congratulations, students.
I didn't plan for a speaker because the program goes long. We wanted to showcase them. So you just get me here at the end as a final thought. I'm going to say a little bit something to my kiddos as they move on, and then I'll speak to the parents. And then we'll be on our way. There will be refreshments afterwards. You're welcome to take pictures and enjoy the rest of that. So I'm going to start with you guys. I'm going to face you because I want to talk to you really quick, and then I'll talk to mommies and daddies, and then we can go. I know you guys have been patiently waiting and doing so well, and you'll get to enjoy some snacks here in just a little bit. And if you haven't had a chance to look at the cake, it has all of your names on the little crayons on it, okay? So to my students, my wish for you is that you see the light in this world and in yourself and in others. This is probably where I'm going to cry, but you guys already knew that. I see the light in you. Compliment others and be proud of your own accomplishments because I'm proud of you. Believe in yourself, for you are stronger than you know. I believe in you. Try hard, but know your limits. Ask if you need help and trust others will help you, and I will help you too. Fill your heart with laughter and smile often. You guys have that down packed. I love to see you smile. You are unique, special, and an amazing little person. There will never be another you. I appreciate all of you. Dream, believe, wonder, inspire, love, nurture, and always listen. That is what I will do for you. And most importantly, always keep Jesus in your heart and choose to be like him. God loves you so much. Never forget that. You belong to God's family. And you will always be a Regalado kid and be a part of my classroom family. Love always. Just for now, your pre-K and K teacher. To the parents. I give you back your child. I return them pounds heavier, inches taller, and 1 year older. It has been my privilege this year to watch them grow in stature as well as maturity. I have observed your child change and stretch their wings toward gaining new independence. It is amazing how much difference a few short months can make. And they did amaze me, even when we did online teaching. I wanted to bring that up because this year's class, there may never be another class that has to do that, and they were even amazing in that. It has truly been a joy to share in your child's life this year. I hope that they have had a truly wonderful experience. Thank you for allowing me to be your child's teacher. It has been a wonderful and rewarding year for me. I will love your child always, and I will pray for your child always. I want to end with my favorite verse. This is my favorite verse because my mom would recite it to me nightly before I went to bed. And it's the blessing found in Numbers 6:23. 24 to 26. May the Lord bless you and protect you. May the Lord smile on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord show you his favor and give you peace. And now Imani is going to have our closing prayer. So if Imani, you can come on up. After Imani prays, we will let the teachers and graduates exit, and then you guys are welcome to come. And a huge thank you to Mr. Tico, as always, who did our processional, and we'll do our recessional, and he plays amazing on the piano. He's our wonderful music director here at Houston Adventist Academy, and we'd like to thank you, Mr. Tico. Okay.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. The kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us all trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation. Deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen.